Well, hello, gentle content beholders. My one photo video thing has died. So, MWR has always wanted me to do video journal entries, so it looks like he'll get his way. I wanted to show you some fire. Fire! It's a candle. All right. Now I'm going to read to you from my journal. Hey, not bad. Entry number 12, June 6th, 2017. This is yesterday's journal entry. I forgot to mention yesterday and forgot to make an appointment with Scott at 2 o'clock p.m. I think I woke up today at about 10 o'clock a.m. My first order of business was to go to STP to apologize to Scott for failing to show up yesterday. Scott had not yet showed up when I got there, so that plan went down the chutes. I was down to 4 smokes and had $3, so I decided it prudent to go turn in some bottles and cans to buy another pack. I went to Whole Foods and was surprised the machine was back up and running. I then went to my tobacco shop, but for some reason they were closed, so I went to the Plaid. I decided it prudent to get going at 2 o'clock p.m. to make my appointment at 4 o'clock p.m., but I still had a good bit of time to kill, so I went to the library to do some uploading and talk to friends on the World Wide Web. I also played some NetHack. While leaving the library at 2 o'clock, there was a fire truck and ambulance in front of the library. I shot a quick video explaining that I had no time to find out why they were there. I went to the clinic on MLK and Killingsworth, where I thought my appointment was. But the receptionist said I had no appointment today. I had considered the possibility that my appointment was at Cascadia, but it was getting late to ride all the way across town. But it was worth the try, especially since I haven't been late for one appointment since I got out of prison on February 3rd or 4th. Official appointment, that is. I've failed to show up for Scott twice. Though I moved quite fast, I was almost a half an hour late. I thought my appointment was with a Dr. Gardner, but it was with a gal named Carly. Carly didn't show up for work today, so if it's all right with the gentle content beholder, I'll say my perfect record still stands. I had made a couple of videos of crossing the Willamette River while trying to make my appointment, and I still had no video of, oh, and I still had the video of the fire truck and ambulance. So I went back to the library to do some uploading and talk to friends on the World Wide Web. There is a local celebrity named Elvis. He's a sort of Elvis impersonator, but he looks nothing like Elvis. Rumor has it, he really thinks he's Elvis. I almost know the guy personally. I gave him an Elvis clock a number of years ago. I recently friended him on Facebook. Anyway, I shot a video of him at the Starlight Parade. So one of the things I wanted to do today was to post my video of his Facebook. Oh, was to post my video on his Facebook wall. I'm pretty sure I eventually succeeded at that. I left the library at about 7 o'clock p.m. I will have to get to reading MWR and Lisa's blogs tomorrow, as I've neglected them the last 2 days. That's a long time, considering they have that contest. From the library, I returned to STP to check off if Scott was there, or had been there today. He wasn't there, but had been there today. Then I went home. After smoking and relaxing, I started this journal entry. I forgot to mention that while still at Cascadia, but after the appointment had been cleared up, I went to the dumpster at the apartment complex across the street and checked them out, having had luck with them in the past. The dumpster was nearly empty, and I estimated unworthy of diving. In the recycling bins, I found a lot of returnable glass bottles and 2 candles, almost burned to the end, and encased in glass. I decided to break the glass on the sidewalk to get the candles out of it. When I got to writing, I originally planned to write by candlelight, but within the small pot I have, the candle wax in it doesn't shed enough light. End of entry.